We framed words like jealousy and envy as a negative thing we shouldn't own up to. But I think it's better to become a student of jealousy and envy, because I think it's the beginning of a healthy discovery that is something inspirational, aspirational in us that may first present in a way that is not good or kind. But I don't think we should dismiss it. So yes, I definitely think if you see something in someone else that first makes you feel jealous, sit with that and figure out what is that that I feel, and let the jealousy thing subside, because when that subsides, it'll still leave you with this sense of yearning or provocation or being inspired or being encouraged or have an idea or think, I want to do something like that. Then that becomes useful. But I think a lot of people lose it early on because it just feels to them, oh, I'm fed up. I could never do that. I wish I could do that. It's okay for them. I don't have that opportunity. I don't come from that background, or whatever it may be. And then it stops there. And that's why a lot of people chuck this stuff out. Yeah. Or I don't know why I'm telling this story, and it stops there. And the story never gets told again. So yes, I think jealousy, envy, all of those things are clues. If you can have the self-awareness clues, rather than you be self-conscious about that and throw it away, self-awareness sees the downside of the potential of jealousy and thinks, well, hang on, let's just stay there for a while, because I think your jealousy is the beginning of being inspired here and seeing someone shine in an area where you want to and will. Definitely.